Hello students, it's a lecture number 2nd of unit 5 and the unit 5 is analysis of arches. So what topic I'm gonna cover I mentioned over here. First is the problems on parabolic arch and second is the analysis of parabolic arch with the supports at different level. So when we going to analyze the parabolic arch, we need some equations and that I have already derived in the previous lecture, lecture number 1 of 5th unit. In that lecture, we have covered first derivation for equation of parabola, for the equation of parabola. Then second equation second derivation which we covered is how to calculate reactions and horizontal thrust. To calculate reactions, we must use equilibrium equations, summation fx, summation fy and moment at A or certain point is equals to 0. That's what we use to calculate reaction RA and RB in the arches. Second derivation is to find horizontal thrust. Where is the horizontal thrust? Here at the supports of arch. In the horizontal thrust derivation, we say that in the horizontal thrust calculation, we see that to find h, we need to take a moment at C or moment at crown position should be equals to 0. You equate the moment at crown position equals to 0 and then you will able to find thrust at supports. Understood? That's what the few topics which we covered in the previous lecture. Now let's focus on the question part, and the very first question from this part is a 3-inch parabolic arch of 20 meter span. So you must remember span is the distance between two supports, right? And that is 20 meter in this arch. And 4 meter central rise carries a point load of 150 kilonewton and rises of 4 meter, right? And this arch carries a 150 kilonewton at 4 meter horizontal from the left hand hinge. This is the left hand hinge and at 4 meter we have a 150 kilonewton point load. Calculate what they asked. They asked us calculate the horizontal thrust and shear force. We require to calculate normal thrust. Let's see again. Normal thrust and shear force at the section under the point load. For the normal thrust, notation is N. For shear force, notation is F. I hope you remember that. Now come to solution. The very first step, see, I am giving you a briefly what is the steps to solve or analyze any arch. For that, first step is find reaction. Second step is find horizontal thrust. And third step is find N and F with the formula. For N, the formula is which we derived in the previous lecture, and for F is also there is one formula which we already did. V cos theta minus H sine theta. Okay, similarly we have formula for N also, which is H cos theta plus V sin theta. Yes, you must have remembered that, which we covered in the previous lecture also. Now let's start to solve this arch. In this arch, the first step is, as I said, support reaction, calculating support reaction. For that, apply a condition of equilibrium. So I used a condition of equilibrium as summation of moment at B is equals to 0. Where is the B? B is here, and for that I have taken a moment calculation. So for that, vertical VA into horizontal distance 20, which is making a clockwise movement, that's why positive. Then next is this HA, but HA is passing through the point of moment, therefore it will not develop any moment at point B. Next is vertical load, next is a vertical load 150 and 150 into horizontal distance up to B. So that's what the equation over here, VA into 20, vertical load is making anti-clockwise moment, therefore I took it as a negative, minus 150 into horizontal distances. If we cancel or subtract 4 from 20, we get a 16 meter as a horizontal distance. From there we calculated VA is equals to 120 kilo Newton. VA is equals to 120 kilo Newton. Now for the summation of Fy, you must remember summation of Fy is nothing but addition of vertical forces. So basically all the vertical forces balances the all vertically downward forces. Understood? So I did over here, VA plus VB must balance downward force of 150 kilonewton. Therefore VA plus VB is equals to 150 kilonewton. From there, in that equation I placed a value of VA, which is 120, and I come to know that VB is 30 kilonewton. Both are acting in upward direction. Now next step, first step is calculating reaction, next step is calculating horizontal thrust. For that, in the derivation we did, consider a region AC in an arch and take a moment at crown equals to 0. You can consider whichever region you want. This is the crown part, and from this crown part you can take first half or you can take a second half, and you may able to calculate moment at crown and equate it equals to 0. That's what I same did over here. For that I need a diagram of arch. I took a first A to C part. Over that I have a vertically downward point load of 150 kilonewton, which is at a distance of 4 meter from A, and this up to the crown distance is 10 meter. Okay, so let's do, and here we have a vertical reaction VA. So VA into horizontal distance up to the crown is VA into 10. Then we have a horizontal force over here, which I mentioned as a HA. HA into vertical distance, which is of 4 meter. Okay, VA into vertical distance 4 meter. VA is making anti-clockwise reaction, anti-clockwise moment. Therefore, I took it VA as a negative. Then next is a 150. This 150 making anti-clockwise towards the crown support or a crown point C, which is 150 into horizontal distances of 6 meter. It's little clumsy, let's do it again. So see, I have did, yes, VA, this is VA into horizontal distance, that's the first part, horizontal distance is a 10 meter. Okay, then for the second part I did horizontal force HA into vertical distance of 4 meter, and then I did, yes, moment calculation for, yes, it's bites clumsy and difficult to solve in this type of software. Yes, it is 150 into horizontal distance up to the crown region is 6 meter. Okay, let's go to the actual thrust. Yes, if we cancel or subtract this is a 10 meter distance. If I subtract 4 meter, we will remain with 6 meter. Okay, so here VA is making clockwise, it is making clockwise moment. HA is making anti-clockwise, and 150 is making anti-clockwise. Accordingly, you take a sign conventions for it. So as I said in the above calculation, take a sign conventions according to your clockwise and anti-clockwise moment. So here in the first part, positive, next is negative, and this should be negative 150 into 6. So please note that here it is negative. The answer is correct. It is 75 kilonewton in the horizontally in the direction of right hand side. Now let's do normal thrust and radial shear. Normal thrust is denoted by N, and radial shear is denoted by F. For that, we need to calculate theta, because in the normal thrust calculation, we have a formula H cos theta, and from there I need to know, to put the value of theta in the equation, I need to know the theta value. For that, a very simple formula which I developed in the very first derivation of previous lecture, that tan theta equals to dy by dx. Okay, from there we get to know that tan theta is equals to 4h by l square into l minus 2x into l minus 2x. Put the value of x into that. What will be the value of x now? X will be the value of arch where they want to calculate n and f value, where they want to calculate n and f value. They want to calculate from us, calculate n and f value at 4 meter distance where point load is applied. So x will be 4 meter, because at a distance of 4 meter they want to asked us to calculate n and f. So therefore I put value of x equals to 4 meter and calculated angle theta. Put the value of x here as a 4 meter and calculate the angle theta. Now come to the next part, where we are actually calculating radial shear F and normal thrust N. Okay, so in the radial shear and normal thrust, what are the requirement? Theta is the first requirement and second is V and H. So we know vertical reaction at A support, vertical reaction at B support, as well as we know horizontal thrust at A and horizontal thrust at B. But now we don't want to put this values in our equation because notation is different. Notation is saying only V. For that, we need to calculate or work out what is V in the our arch. So see, they asked us to calculate shear force N and F. Shear force F and N is a normal thrust at a distance 4 meter from the left hand support of a arch. There I am gonna calculate V and H value. How I am gonna calculate that? See here. For that, I have taken a section, or I have cut that part in a section. It is not okay. That's the arch, right? And I have taken a section over here at a distance of 4 meter. Then I draw a tangent at a point. This is the tangent I have drawn, which is N, which is radial, which is normal thrust denoted by N. And for shear force, radial shear, I have taken a perpendicular to the normal line. To the normal thrust line, I have taken a perpendicular. So what I did, I have taken a section first, then I drawn a tangent at edge of that section, and to that perpendicular, I draw a perpendicular line. A tangent denotes normal thrust and perpendicular line shows radial shear or denoted by F. Okay, understood? Now come to the calculation part. This is your radial shear. This is your normal thrust. I have taken a vertical, let's change the color for that so it will be a better understanding for you. Yes, this is your vertical line and this is your horizontal line, which is for our reference we have drawn that. Now to calculate radial shear, I need to know what is V and H. To calculate V and H, I did equilibrium equations. I take a help of equilibrium equations. Do the summation of Fx and summation of Fy at this section. For the summation of Fx, horizontal forces HA, horizontal forces HA minus H. What is HA now? HA is a horizontal thrust at A. Okay, and what is H is? H is, you can see over here, if we go back, you can see, yes, it is HA and it is 75. Okay, HA is horizontal thrust at A and H is horizontal force at a section. Understood? I did a summation of Fx for that and get to know the horizontal force acting at a section from 4 meter of a support A is 75. Now I want to know vertical force acting into it. For that I will do summation of Fy. From what will be come into the summation of Fy now? In the summation of Fy I will do vertical force VA, which is vertical reaction at A support, plus is the upward, then minus will be the 150. Where is the 150? We know at exactly 4 meter distance from A support, there is a point load of 150. So I said negative 150. That is not possible to mention in the diagram. That's why I haven't shown in this diagram. But you must remember there is a 150 kilonewton load in the 4 meter in the arch at a distance of 4 meter, which is downward in direction. Therefore, I took it as a negative. And also at the same point, we have plotted V, vertically downward force V. That is this. It is again in downward direction, therefore I took it as a negative. Solve this equation. VA is already known, which is 120 kilonewton. From there we get to know vertical force acting at that section 4 meter from the left hand side is negative 30. Understood? Now radial shear calculation. Radial shear F formula. Now only the formula is important. Rest is a putting values into that formula. Formula is V cos theta minus H sin theta. Minus is important. In the normal thrust formula, H cos theta. Better I underline this. H cos theta plus V sin theta. In the radial shear, V cos theta minus sin theta. Put a value of theta, V and H and find the values of normal thrust and radial shear. Here we ended our first problem in which we work out what we did. We have taken an arch. We calculated vertical reactions first, then horizontal thrust Then we did section at 4 meter, where they want to calculate us normal thrust and radial shear. We took a section over there. Then we did summation fx and fy to know v and n, and then we put the values of v, n, and along with that we did a tan theta to find theta, and with the help of this three values we find out radial shear and normal thrust. That's the basic procedure. Now read the second question. We will solve now second question. In the second question, they said there is a 3-inch parabolic arch, has a span of 24 meter and a central rise of 4 meter, carries a concentrated load of 50 kilonewton in second half. Okay, at 18 meter, at distance of 18 meter from the left support, determine thrust and radial shear at a section 6 meter. Okay, they want us to calculate radial shear and normal thrust at section 6 meter from the left support. Understood? Now let's solve the problem. First step in the solving this problem is calculating reactions RA and RB. For that, let's do the summation of Fy and moment at A equals to 0. See here, from the summation of Fy, we know vertical forces is equals to downward force. So Va plus Vb equals to 50. Then moment at A equals to, at this region, equals to 0. So starting from the another support, it is making anti-clockwise moment. So Vb into horizontal distance, total horizontal distance is 12 plus 12, 24. Okay, plus this is making clockwise moment, which is plus 50 into horizontal distance is 18 meter. That's it. We can't take a horizontal thrust Vb in calculation because it is passing through the point of moment calculation. Understood? From there we get Vb equals to 37.5, Va equals to 12.5. Okay. Now time to calculate horizontal thrust Ha and Hb. For calculating horizontal thrust, we know that we need to calculate moment at crown and equate it equals to 0. So for moment at a crown, I have taken a region A to C. At A, there is a vertical reaction and horizontal thrust. Vertical reaction is Va, horizontal thrust is Ha. Horizontal distance up to the crown is 12 meter and vertical distance is 4 meter. Okay, so from here we can write an equation of moment Va, which is making clockwise moment, positive into 12, where horizontal thrust making anti-clockwise moment, minus Ha into vertical distance 4, equating to 0. That's what I wrote over here. You can see from there I get to know Ha is equals to 37.5 and Hb is exactly same but in opposite direction, 37.5. Now third step is to calculate normal thrust and radial shear. For the normal thrust and radial shear, the very first thing which we required is a tan theta and finding a theta value. Then find V and H. For that you have to take a section in the arch. Let's start doing it. First we did at x 6 meter, where at 6 meter where we take a section, what is the angle theta there? Angle theta is equal to, you can find a vertical distance over there. I found a vertical distance with the help of y or a equation of parabola. Equation of parabola is nothing but the vertical distance at a crown, right? So I take a help of that equation, 4h in divide by l square into x l minus x, and from there I calculated ve, which is nothing but the vertical distance at a point of sections where question asked us to calculate N and F. But I found this step is unnecessary. We are not required this value of V anywhere. That's why you can skip this part. Come to the next part is calculating tan theta. But you must remember, we must calculate tan theta at a distance of 6 meter where we take a section, where we going to take a section. Therefore, x in this formula is 6 meter. From there, I calculated, if I solve this whole equation, equation for tan theta is, tan theta is equals to, nothing is new over here, only the formulas and values are different. Formulas are same, 4h divided by l square into l minus 2x. That is the formula for tan theta. Put the value of x in this formula as a 6 meter. You must remember this part. This is important. Where you want to calculate theta? At a distance of 6 meter, where we took a section. From there we calculated theta as a 18.43. Now the time to calculate h and v. For that I have taken a section in the arch. This is the tangent. This is the arch, right? I have taken a tangent. Right, this tangent at a edge of arch, which is denotes N, and I draw a perpendicular to that tangent, which denotes F. Now I want to take a vertical force V and horizontal force H, and now support reaction at A and horizontal thrust at A. From this diagram, we will do summation of Fx and summation of Fy that I have done here. Yes, that calculation is not mentioned. We will do just beside this diagram. For summation of Fx, see now, why I have not done that calculation? You must understand that. That calculation is not added over here because see, in this region of arch, there is no point load. Even there is no UDL. But if you remember in the previous question, in that arch at a point of 4 meter distance, there was a V as well as there was a downward force of 150 kN, which will change our force of V and horizontal force H. Okay, but in this problem, in the region of A to C, there is no point load, nor even a UDL, is present. Therefore, no need to worry. You can directly place the values of V and H. How we will directly place that? See, 12 is a vertical force over here. You can place downward force. Of course, this 12 will be balanced by horizontal, vertically downward force V. And horizontal force 37.5 at A will be balanced by the horizontal force at a section, which is H. Therefore, no need to calculate separately. From here, we get to know vertical force is 12.5 and horizontal force is 37.5. Hope you understood. If you not understood, do with the traditional way by summation of Fx and summation of Fy, you will get same answers. Let's calculate now N and F. Nothing to do over here, just write down the formulas, put the values of theta, N and V. Don't forget the negative sign in the F calculation. From that, I understood the F is 0 and N is 39.62. Now let's solve one more problem, third problem of this lecture, and the statement of this problem is, the statement of this problem is equation of 3-inch parabolic arch with origin at its left support. It means that there is an arch which is 3-inched and equation is given by the y and origin is A support. Okay, then okay, because whatever equation we are following to analyze the arches with the origin of A, and they have also given an equation that is by different but origin is same, so we can work it out. You must check that sub origin of that equation must be a left support A, then no problem to go ahead. Next, what they ask, the span of the arch is 48 meter. Okay, the arch is carrying a uniformly distributed load of 20 kilonewton per meter over half left. Okay, left matlab yahi side ho gaya A to C. In the A to C we have UDL of 20 kilonewton per meter. Understood? And they are asking us to determine the horizontal reaction at the support. Only horizontal reaction, no need to calculate N and F. Okay, we will do that. Now first part is, see, in the whole question they haven't mentioned what is the vertical rise of a arch, because they haven't given you a arch diagram in this problem. Therefore, I'm gonna draw arch for you. If such a question asked in university, you have to draw on your own the diagram of arch. So to draw a diagram of arch, it is easy. But they haven't mentioned what is the value of vertical rise. So we need to find out vertical or a rise first of all, and then we will draw a diagram for arch. For that we need to take a formula of y. So see, y, a formula of parabolic equation is, equation of parabola is y is equals to l, sorry, yes, y is equals to 4h divided by, it is not properly writing, yes, y equals to 4h divided by l square in bracket, here is a x, l minus x, right? Hope you remember. Now focus over here. This is the equation they mentioned in the question, right? If we put c equals to 4 meter, c equals to 4 meter, c equals to 24 meter at x equals to 24. The arch is this, and total span of arch they said 48 meter, right? 48 meter. And I put x equals to 24, it will exactly end at a crown, right? And y is nothing but the vertical distance. So if I place x equals to 24 in the equation, I will get a vertical distance at crown. Vertical distance at crown. And vertical distance at crown is nothing but h, rise of our parabola, right? So that's how we gonna find h value. I put at C x equals to 24, and from there I get to know vertical distance as at crown or rise of our arch is 9.6 meter. You put into the equation, you will get a 9.6 meter. Now second thing they asked us is calculation of support reactions. It is very easy. How to calculate support reaction? By applying equilibrium equations. What are the equilibrium equations? Summation of fx, fy and moment at a particular point equals to 0. So I took a summation of moment at A equals to 0. From there, I have started from the extreme support RB into horizontal distances 48, right? That I mentioned it is making anti-clockwise, that's why I mentioned negative value. Next is this UDL. UDL is of 10 kilonewton. UDL is of 10 kilonewton. From there, yes, here it is 10 kilonewton. 10 into 24. 24 is the this span. 24. into 12, 12 is what? At exactly center, we will consider a concentrated load of 10 into 24, and the horizontal distance is 12 of that. So I got RB equals to 120. Understood? The calculation is correct. You can check into the book. Yes, if you calculate with the help of this equation, RB into 48, this RB into 48 horizontal distance, 20, which is actually UDL mentioned in this problem, is sorry. UDL mentioned over here is 10. So here it must be 10 into horizontal distance into this perpendicular distance, right? So 10 into 24 into 12, that becomes, reaction becomes 60 over here. You can calculate on your own, and this RA also becomes, if we put this value into summation of FY, wait a minute. Yes, summation of FY says RA plus RB equals to how much? This 10 into this distance. 10 into how much? This distance is 24. So 10 into 24, it will be 240. 240 minus this is 60. 240 minus 60 will be 180. Right? So there will be a correction in the problem, but I hope you understood the procedure behind it. Now horizontal thrust H. To calculate horizontal thrust, take a moment at crown equals to 0, and from there that calculation, moment calculation, gives us horizontal thrust at B equals to 300. For that, check it out, moment equation again. Yes, moment equation at crown. We will start in from this region now. Because see, if you start from the A to C, from this region, you need to take a calculation of this extra load. But if you gone, if you used second region for calculation of moment at a crown, there will not be only reaction and horizontal thrust. So I used second equation, second region of our arch. So RB into 24, which is, this is the RB, and horizontal distance up to crown is 24, and horizontal thrust here into vertical distance, which is 96. It is making clockwise moment, that's why I took positive, and this vertical reaction making anti-clockwise, that's why I taken a negative value. Therefore we got RB equals to HB equals to 300. Understood? Now last problem of this unit, from this lecture, is UDL, same 10 kilonewton UDL is placed in the first half of your arch, and they asked us a N and F, is that normal thrust and radial shear at a distance of 5 meter from the A support. For that, first step is calculating reaction, second step is calculating horizontal thrust, then third step is calculate theta, V and H and put it into the formulas. Understood? So let's go step by step to solve this arch. To calculate support reactions, yes, apply equilibrium equation. So I use summation of Fy first. So when you do summation of Fy, vertical force at A, vertical force at B will balance the downward force. How much is the downward force? 10 into this distance, 10 into half of 25, which is 12.5. From there I got Va plus Vb is equals to 125. Then summation of moment at A, this is the A, from left we start, from the left first is Vb into horizontal distance. How much is the horizontal span? 25. Then next is 10 into 12.5. From this region you should also consider in calculation, right? We are going from this side, so we considered this. H B will not come into the moment calculation because it is passing to the A point. Understood? It will not develop any moment. Then 10 into horizontal distance. 10 into 12.5 into horizontal distance 6.25. From there we calculated VB equals to 32.5. VB is equals to how much? 32.5. And VA is equals to 93.75. I have mentioned the values of VA and VB in the arch. You must work it out before and then write it down in your arch. Now horizontal thrust. To calculate horizontal thrust, again take a moment at C or crown equals to 0. To calculate moment at a crown, you can take one of the two regions. You can take A to C or from B to C. I have calculated from B to C. And why I have calculated from B to C? Because this extra force is not needed to calculate or take into consideration while calculating moment at crown from this region. That's why I have taken a second region of this arch. And from that calculation, I get to know horizontal thrust at B is 48.82 and horizontal thrust at A is 48.82 kilonewton. Now let's go to the last step of this problem, is calculating normal thrust and radial shear. But where they asked us at a section of 5 meter. They asked us at a distance of 5 meter. They asked us at a distance of 5 meter. Okay. Now, first calculation will be for theta. What is the formula for theta? 4h by l square in bracket l minus 2x. But x will be a distance of section where they want to calculate n and f. Therefore, x will be 5 meter, and there we calculated theta by putting a value of x in a formula of dy by dx. Now to summation of fx. Before that, let's understand this diagram. I have taken a section at 5 meter. I drawn a tangent to that, which is mentioned by n. Exactly perpendicular to it, I have drawn radial shear force denoted by f. Then I applied a vertically downward force at that section and horizontal force h. And vertically downward force v, this one. Understood? And UDL is already there in that region, which is of 10 kilonewton per meter. Now let's do summation of Fy and summation of Fx. Yes. Summation of Fx says horizontal force. This is horizontal force, which is negative inside, negative H, plus positive 48.82. Therefore, horizontal force at H will be 48.82. Understood? Now summation of Fy. For summation of Fy, we will consider all the vertical forces. How many are the vertical forces? Vertically downward V, UDL of 10 kilonewton, this one, and next is this force 93.73, which is the reaction at A support. Let's do this calculation. Calculation is mentioned over here, vertical reaction, which will be positive, then downward UDL, which will be negative, and downward vertical force will be negative. From that we get a vertically downward force at section as a 43.75 and horizontal force at a section is 48.82. Put this values of theta, horizontal force and vertical force in formulas of N and F. Don't forget the negative sign in a F calculation. From there, we get to know N is 65.36 and F is 4.96. Understood? Clear? Now, last topic of our lecture is 3-hinge parabolic arch with the supports at different level. You can see in this arch, The supports are not at same level. Hinge is not ended over here. The second region of your arch is extended further, and that's why there is a level difference between A support and B support. That's what we call supports are at different level. When such an arch is need to be analyzed, we have to consider different formulas of lengths and equation of parabola, which I mentioned over here. L1 is this length, L2 is a second length, and equation of parabola for this region is mentioned here. And equation of parabola for the second region is mentioned in this part. Now simple trick is there to learn this formulas. Shortcut way is, if we want to calculate L1, write down L into under the under root H1 divide by H1 plus H2. For L2, L into what will be the in the numerator side? H2. That's the simple trick. And denominator of this formula is remain same. Similarly here, for the parabolic equation of arch of A and B, you can get an idea about it to learn this formulas and keep into mind and try to solve. Like, homework for this lecture is here, our lecture is ended. Homework for today's lecture is solve one numerical on three hinge parabolic arch to calculate N and F. Thank you.